Hello everyone, we are going to perform the variable effective G pendulum experiment. The aim of this experiment is to determine the acceleration due to gravity by means of a compound pendulum and also to find the radius of gyration about an axis through the center of gravity for the compound pendulum. Also, we are investigating the dependence of value of effective G on the plane of oscillation of the pendulum. The apparatus required for this experiment are a compound pendulum setup with a 1 meter long rod, a meter scale to measure the length, and a stopwatch to measure the time period of oscillation. Now, attach the rod to the stand and tighten the knobs. There is also a knob to adjust the plane of oscillation with an angular scale. Make sure that the rod is aligned vertical. In the first part of our experiment, we change the length of pendulum and find corresponding time periods. So, fix the rod at a particular length close to either one of the ends and measure the length between one end and the attached point. Then, oscillate the pendulum in small angles and measure the time taken for 10 oscillations using a stopwatch. Repeat this process 3 times and find the mean and divide it by 10 to get the time period. Now, adjust the rod to another length and find the corresponding time period as we discussed earlier. Repeat this process for several lengths throughout one half of the rod. In the first table, note down the lengths of the pendulum. Then, 3 measurements of time taken for 10 oscillations and their mean. Divide it by 10 to get the time period. We have to plot a graph with distance of clamp n from the center of gravity on x-axis and the time period on y-axis. Now, draw several lines parallel to x-axis and intersecting 2 points on the curve. For each of these lines, find the length of equivalent simple pendulum and radius of gyration as described in the manual. Fill the second table with these values for each line in the plot. That is the length of equivalent simple pendulum, radius of gyration, and corresponding time period. From these values, we can calculate the value of G corresponding to each data set. Now, we move to the second part of our experiment. Choose a length which is having the lowest time period. Adjust the knob to change the plane of oscillation and note down corresponding angle. Find the time period of pendulum as we discussed earlier. Adjust the pendulum to a different angle and repeat the procedure. Do this for several angles and fill the table 3 with corresponding time periods. Complete the table with required quantities. Use the value obtained from previous sections for the radius of gyration k. Identify how effective g is changing with plane of oscillation. Plot a graph between 4 pi square k square plus l square by l cos phi and t square using the data from this table. Analyze the graph and find value of g.